has been a terrorist act, America will retaliate for what they did to our people as they flew in the air over Long Island.
Today I was given a vision about the whereabouts of Osama bin Laden. It was in a city close to Faisalabad, Pakistan.
Bin Laden is dead. The U.S. intelligence community got wind that bin Laden was hiding somewhere in Pakistan.
Israel is forever.
And the Jewish state will live forever.
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 God says, Ford will be revived. This one nation shall experience what they predicted for this nation, an earthquake in Japan.
A new group of terrorists are emerging. They will train pilots to plunge, to attack, to steal.
Former Iraqi military officers who have defected to ISIS are now teaching their fellow Sunni extremists how to operate the planes.
Oh, New Orleans, enough of this. Enough! I will take the men that have stood in faith, raise them above the flood that shall destroy those that constantly bicker and stand against my servant Moses.
What is happening in Egypt? They'll get tired of singing Allah, and they'll start singing about Yeshua.
There is a man by the name of Mr. Clark, and there is also another man by the name of Donald. You are both watching me saying, could it be that God's speaking to me? Yes, he is. Somebody, just a few minutes before you came on the show, you went out and you took the American flag and you said, I'm proud of my nation. And you raised it up and God said, you have been determined through your prayers to influence this nation. You're watching me. You're an influential person. The Spirit of God says, hear the word of the prophet to you as a king. I will open that door that you prayed about. And when it comes time for the election, you will be elected.
There will be a praying president, not a religious one. But I will fool the people, says the Lord. I will fool the people. Yes, I will. God says, the one that is chosen shall go in, and they shall say, he has hot blood. For the Spirit of God says, yes, he may have hot blood, but he will bring the walls of protection on this country in a greater way, and the economy of this country shall change rapidly, says the Lord of hosts. Listen to the word of the Lord. God says, I will put at your helm for two terms. A president that will pray, but he will not be a praying president when he starts. I will put him in office and then I will baptize him with the Holy Spirit and my power, says the Lord of hosts. I see a president that shall come. And this is not to speak bad about this one. There is a president who will come. And God says he will have absolutely no fear. Absolutely no fear. Will be decisive, make decisions. And then in the middle of the restoration of America, rapidly, because of a source of energy that shall come quickly. And because of medical breakthroughs and because of agreements between nations, specifically China, God said they shall say, we never dreamed this would happen. Where they shall say, Christ will reign, and this we shall not implement at all socialism, where they have said, we will make history without God. No, you will not. No, you will not, says the Lord.
For they are saying, how do we kill the giant? How do we kill the giant of debt? How do we kill the giant of socialism? How do we kill the giant of human secularism? I have placed that man amongst you. Take all these little remarks I'm giving you. They are gems. The name and the word gold. And God says, these that shall reject him shall be shocked at how he takes the giant down. But God said, watch, I said 20,000. Look not to Wall Street, however, observe. And they shall say, what is your plan for this giant? And he will take a simple stone. Remember the name. And he will hold it up and they will laugh at him. But the plan is so brilliant, says the Lord. It could only have been given by me. They will shout, impeach, impeach. But this shall not happen. And then God says, highly embarrassing moments when another Snowden arises. And people will become very afraid. And God says, healing shall begin and then it shall flow rapidly. Schools will be free from potential damage and danger, shootings and murder, drug addiction. Cartels shall be afraid of a woman. A woman anointed by God. A woman set aside. And God says, they will say we hated her, but now we love her. For she shall take the oil of healing and she shall pour it upon the scars of those left and those right, and of the new party that has come forth and emerged. Therefore, the healing that is necessary for this nation shall come at a time in the middle of the presidency. There shall be a woman that shall come. And God said, there shall be oil that shall be poured upon the nation. And they shall suddenly feel the healing. And they shall say, it is well with my soul. It is well with our soul. For the soul of America has been corrupted. The soul of this nation has been corrupted with bitterness and anger. And God said, she shall say, no more bitterness. No more anger. No more divisions.
I was overwhelmed by a strong presence of hatred and bitterness permeating from the citizens of the United States of America. When I sensed this, I sensed I was literally tasting the bitterness. Not that would only come, but that is present. And God was so grieved that politics and the economy and the news media has put us in a position where we are completely corrupted in our hearts, and bitterness is coming forth instead of praying prophetically, calling out to God.
Suddenly the Spirit came, removed from my eyes scales. I was praying for America and I was praying for Israel. Nothing unusual. And suddenly behind me, starting behind my back, going in the form of an arrow, were hundreds of thousands of people. And I turned around and I was stunned at what I saw. This was not just a mere dream, but this was a vision. And so I raised my hand like this, and every one of them raised their hands. I looked back and they were doing the same thing. I shouted and they all shouted. They were one. They were one. One party. One party of people. It continued until I realized that the unity of these Amongst them stood one that God had set aside to be the leader of this nation. And then I heard gold. I wasn't sure if this was attached to his name, but he said to me, he will restore the fortunes in this nation because of his brilliance. I couldn't quite see his face because that was not allowed, because there was a mist that covered all the people and he was amongst them. And the Spirit of God made me look at him and he said, this man will throttle the enemies of Israel. This man will throttle the enemies of the West. And there are highly embarrassing moments that are about to occur for many, many politicians in this nation. And then there is a nation, he showed me and took me, itching for a new kind of war with America. This nation shall come very subtly, but he shall not come in the time of President Obama. They shall come when this new one arises, my David, that I have set aside for this nation. For they are saying, how do we kill the giant? How do we kill the giant of death? How do we kill the giant of socialism? How do we kill the giant of human secularism? I have placed that man amongst you. The name and the word gold. Remember that. And God says, these that shall reject him shall be shocked at how he takes the giant down. And they shall say, what is your plan for this giant? And he will take a simple stone. Remember the name. And he will hold it up and they will laugh at him. But the plan is so brilliant, says the Lord. It could only have been given by me. Come on! They will shout, impeach, impeach, they say. But nay. They will shout, impeach, impeach, but this shall not happen. And then God says, highly embarrassing moments when another Snowden arises. And people will become very afraid. They'll say, we have no protection. And then God says, am I impressed with your weapons of war? Am I impressed with the strength of your men's legs? Ha! I have said I will bring this nation to its knees. And God said, you have been humbled. And yet some more. And then you shall hear the sounds of great victory. For where are the people gathered? Where are my people gathered? Where is the sound of unity from my people? And God says, once you recognize the man that I have raised up, pray. For the enemy will do everything in his power to put a witch in the White House. Did anybody hear what he just said? For Jezebel has chased away the prophets and even Elijah.
Come on.
Now I have said, go back. For this shall be dismantled so that there will be no more corruption in the White House, says the Spirit. Lord, I pray today with your people. I call to you, Lord, because you have shown me New York. You've shown me New York. You've shown me, Lord, how the enemy has once again planned something, but this time it is completely different. It is not like 9/11. There is nothing like it. This is the most strange infiltration that shall come upon your screens. It shall come upon you in your movie houses. It shall come upon the places of comfort and pleasure.
and they shall infiltrate, and they shall say, we'll even black them out. We will even cause them to be so terrorized because there is darkness in one section and darkness in another section. Canada, keep your shield in front of you. Do not let it down, for they are focusing on you.
The Spirit of God says, one more thing I want to talk to you about. That little dwarf in North Korea, I'm getting a little tired of him. I think I'm going to go and pay him a visit, says the Lord. You watch and see what I do.
Come on.
And that will be a big sign that the man that I'm sending with a stone for the giant is emerging, says the Lord. Prophesy and shout it out.
Positive about what is going to happen with mankind, what is going to happen to the nations of the earth. If you look at what's happening today with Russia, you see the Cold War era almost wanting to come back, a revisitation of the Cold War between Russia and China. We see what's taking place. Can it be changed? Yes. How did God do it in the Cold War era at the time? He had a Ronald Reagan. And it was a Ronald Reagan that stood up and took away the tumor. Now we see that this is trying to grow again and trying to come back to where there'll be this cold, this coldness between Russia and America, and trying to bring back an era. And I see it happening. But to me, it tells me that there will be another kind of Ronald Reagan that has to be emerged, that has to be raised up, so that this will take care of the tumor within the nations of the world. It's history repeating itself. I'm telling you right now, what is going to happen after Barack Obama is you're going to see what's going to start transpiring. It may not happen in the very next election, maybe afterwards, but you'll see as this accumulates and there's a threat of war amongst nations, God will once again raise up a man that will deal with it. And that's what I'm looking to. But I'm saying,
can my ecclesia be destroyed? Never. Yes, we know there will be tribulation, and so it shall be, and my people shall join me. But before that time, there is a global awakening. No, not just one town and city, not just one country, but many. Look how I invaded Egypt. You see, most people don't know this, but it was in Arabia that John the Baptist was beheaded. And it is in Arabia, and Saudi Arabia shall and has persecuted more Christians than you realize. But God, I said, I will now make them accountable. How shall I do this? I will prosper the very country that they hate, calling them the great Satan. New energy is arising. And God says, even though oil shall always be fought after, there shall be burning and burning and burning like you have never seen. And there shall be fights and antagonism, but I cannot unfortunately do it now, as I'm stuck with one who has decided not to fight Islam, not to fight radical Islam. But God said, I will cause a new one to rise up in this nation. And God said, there will be a prophetic anointing that shall carry you until that year. And that prophetic anointing, says the Lord, will bring prosperity to the soil of this country and to the families of this nation. Yes, they have sinned. America is not guiltless. But God said, when I weigh the balance, when I weigh the scales, when I set out the scales, there is great iniquity in Saudi Arabia and all over that region. And therefore, watch with your eyes as the earth shakes, and watch how this prosperity comes. For now, I set the prophetic seal upon my house and upon my church to prosper and prosper and prosper even more, says the Lord of hosts. I see a king falling. I see a king falling. Saudi Arabia, Yemen, Solomon, Lord, you are not pleased. The wall, there's a wall being built that will not be completed for a takeover. Already a plan. Iran, you have wicked plans. Your wickedness cannot be covered. I've seen you, says the Lord. I've already spoken about you. Father, I just pray you'd stop just for a minute.
For many years ago, in a higher regency, my prophet stood and prophesied. And yes, said the Lord, it did happen. But I raised up a man that stood against Islam. I raised up a man that stood against the war, against the nations that would come against Israel. Where is that man? I call for that man now, says the Lord. I call for that man again to come onto the scene and take the seat in the White House and be a noble president, says the Lord.
His name was David, one of the greatest men ever. King David, whom that anointing, whether you like it or not, doesn't matter. That anointing shall be set upon the soil and at the capital of the United States of America for the new years to come. They are even in California right now, and they have proposed to do certain things on the television so that they will grab a hold of a network and they'll be able to do something. God said, this is no small thing, but hear me out. I have watched them and I have said, enough is enough. I will use my prophets and I will use my priests to raise up a voice and to make a sound. You are safe, says the Lord. You are not safe because of your president. You are not safe because of the White House or the Pentagon. You are safe because of the kingdom of God that exists, and because there are a remnant of people that will stand and fight, says the Spirit of the Lord. Now, have you watched? Have you watched as my people have prayed that in the fall, have you watched? Have you seen the games that they play in the house they call white? Do you see the game that they play, says the Lord? What is this game that is being played between those that are anonymous, who say they do not mean what they say? Watch. I listen to the prayers of the forefathers and the present fathers to bring what I promised to this nation. Would your greatest enemy stand on the Capitol, at the Capitol, and declare, away with you, dove, away with you, spirit, away with you, Yeshua. No, it shall not be, but you shall be afraid as you hear these things, but also mesmerized as I place many into a sleep, that I may draw out of them the beauty of the bride. This, watch and see, says the Lord. Now, as I have placed the wall that represents Hezekiah's faith that prayed, he turned his face to the wall, and he prayed to the Lord. Today I want you to join me in praying this prayer, because I tell you what's happening. When God spoke a few minutes ago, you will see. He spoke about a hypnotic November. And I said, Lord, the word hypnosis
does not sit well with me. And God said, this is different. There shall be a lulling. You know, hypnosis puts you to sleep. God said, this that is going to happen is going to be mesmerizing. During November and December, where I will expose one after the other. And people in this nation shall look and say, we have to call upon the name of the Lord.
What about your children? What about them, says the Lord? That's what the enemy wants, to cripple your economy and to cripple your children. But the Spirit of God says, they will breathe in the air that is pure, for I will take the air of this nation and I will purify it, says the Spirit of the Lord. For they want an inoculation against that which is being sent into this country, but it is not being sent in from outside, says the Lord. It is already inside this nation. Your enemies are within, says the Lord, and I will wipe them out one at a time. But before I do, I shall go over to the land where you are having war, and I will strike down the enemy quicker than you imagine, says the Lord. I will cause a spirit of betrayal to arise, and the people will be afraid. Great fear shall come upon them. Great fear shall come upon them, says the Lord. Not because of the strength of America, and not because of the strength of the religious, because the Lord said, I determined this day that I will do what I'm going to do, and I shall do it, says the Lord, for the sake of your children and your children's children. Therefore rejoice, for the battle has begun, but it shall end swiftly with a great shout of victory, says the Lord. Before I do anything else, this drew it out of me. I'd been in all week, I've been carrying this. And now, and I was carried above the, I was carried above a table with Putin and four others. I did. I saw them writing things which I am not permitted to speak now. Otherwise, I won't be alive next week. I am not permitted to speak this now, but there will come a point when I can share it with the right authorities. And I will do it. And I will do it as I go to Israel. That is my duty. That is what he called me to do. I need your prayer. I need your covering. Jane needs your covering. My children need your covering. Our team need your covering. Prayer covering for protection. This is no small thing, people. It may seem like a small building here, but there are literally millions that are watching all over the world at some point in time. And not many of them are friends. Many of them are great enemies. Russia, you wimp. You double-minded, deceitful liar. You plan behind their back, smile to their face with your crooked teeth. God said, I will not tolerate this indignant.
Now we see that this is trying to grow again and trying to come back to where there'll be this coldness between Russia and America, trying to bring back an era. And I see it happening. To me, it tells me that there will be another kind of Ronald Reagan that has to be emerged, that has to be raised up, so that this will take care of the tumor within the nations of the world.
The three nations that have ruled in the Middle East, they shall come down without the necessity of a war from the United States of America. No more war. For 20 years, this nation shall be free of a war.
But Europe will be affected in the same way that Daniel was praying. There was a war in the heavenlies. Prince of Persia, there was a battle going on, as there is today. A war will take place. It shall be short-lived, because as France destroyed the power of invasion from the Middle East in the 7th century, so shall it rise up and destroy the invading forces from the beast of the East. There will be a second reformation in Europe. God says, I will begin in France
Islam, Buddha, Asia here, Jesus. Jesus shall crush every tribe, every nation, every language from the sound, from this place. It shall never end, and the battle shall be won. That word is Yeshua, 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 Jesus. Jesus.
But Europe will be affected.
L'Europe sera affectée.
And the same way that Daniel was praying.
Et de la même façon que Daniel a prié.
There was a war in the heavenlies.
Il y a eu une guerre dans les lieux célestes.
Prince of Persia.
Et le prince de la Perse.
There was a battle going on.
Il y a eu une bataille qui a été.
As there is today.
Comme il y a aujourd'hui.
And France.
Et la France.
Shall join forces.
Va joindre.
With Great Britain,
avec la Grande-Bretagne,
and some other nations,
et avec d'autres nations,
there will be a war.
Et il y aura une guerre.
It shall be a short war.
Une guerre courte.
Hear me, please.
Écoutez-moi bien.
This war,
cette guerre,
and I'm not talking about a spiritual war.
Et là, je ne parle pas d'une guerre spirituelle.
A war will take place.
Il y aura une guerre.
It shall be short-lived.
Une guerre très courte.
Because as France,
parce que comme la France
destroyed the power,
a détruit le pouvoir
of invasion,
de l'envahisseur
from the Middle East,
et des envahisseurs du Moyen-Orient,
in the 7th century,
dans le 7e siècle,
so shall it rise up,
alors la France se lèvera,
and destroy the invading forces,
et va détruire aussi des forces
from the beast of the East,
qui viendront de l'Est,
and they will overcome,
et nous allons vaincre.
An agreement
et nous allons vaincre un accord
between Russia
entre la Russie
and Iran.
There is a storm brewing, says the Lord, but this is not a natural one. And God said there will be a great massive fight, just one war. One war shall manifest on four different countries. The beast of the East, who has said we will remove Christianity in total from Europe, America, Israel. We will remove their God and we will bring Allah. There is a storm brewing, but God says, I have already prepared the angels. I have already prepared an outpouring, and that which is dying shall suddenly come back to life. Russia, Africa, Italy, Germany, France. Of rain, says the Lord. Come on.
I'll use Germany. I'll use Italy. Yes. I'll use Holland, the Netherlands. I'll use France. They will stand, and they will stand against the Spirit. And that'll be the countries that I'll begin a great reformation. And there will be an abolishment of the laws of men. And your young men and young women shall rise, 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 and shout, shout, shout. Everyone in this building, say this with me. Those who are with us,
those who are with us,
are greater than those who are against us. I'm talking about the angels of the Lord that are with us. You don't believe me, my friend. I want to tell you something. We blind. God's raising up young Davids and young Samuels. And they're going to begin to prophesy to the dead bones. And they're going to bring life to this nation and to Europe again, says the Lord. Those who are with us are greater than those who are against us.
I'm Jacqueline Clement. Thank you for watching our YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and you can find all the information about our ministry and my father in the description below. Thank you for watching with us today.